Welcome to the Press Box, a presentation presented by Zeglin's TV and Appliance through the Dispatch and the Rock Island Argus. I am Dispatch Argus sports reporter Daniel Makarewicz. Joining with me to my left is Dispatch Argus sports reporter Anthony Sandoval. And in the middle is Mr. Marc Nesseler, Dispatch Argus sports editor. He is slightly under the weather. He does not have a voice. So I'm sure he and neither does his bobblehead. So neither Marc Nesseler nor his bobblehead has a voice for the Press Box. So he'll be sitting here in the middle, bobbling and weaving, as Anthony and I discuss this week's prep football action. Anthony, you are the Geneseo beat writer. Yep. You have seen the Maple Leafs start off 5-0. What has gone well for them this season?
Well, I mean, their schedule definitely isn't up to par. It wasn't very good in the first half of the season, but Geneseo has done some impressive things. 5-0 is 5-0. They've won five games.
With four shutouts, I believe.
Four shutouts. Yep. The only game they really gave up anything, they gave up all their points in the one game to Eisenhower, and Eisenhower was
athletic.
They did some nice things. The thing I like about last week's game was they were missing two offensive linemen and still managed to rush for 407 yards. So, I mean, that's impressive. They do great things with Will Daniels can throw the ball nicely, and I mean their defense has been good since Jake Yarger's been back.
The big question that I've had all year, and I've voiced it, is that schedule. I just don't think that they were tested very well in the non-conference, and you can't in your conference you can't control that. Oh, yeah. Do you think at some point that schedule is going to create some issues for them down the road? Maybe not be properly tested when they get into the playoffs. Maybe, you know, be in situations where they're not used to because they've had so many easy victories.
I fear that could be a case, but Larry Johnson Jr. does a great job getting those kids prepared every week. This half of the schedule is way tougher. They have Yorkville this week, Sterling State ranked, I believe.
DeKalb. Back-to-back road games.
Yep, and Ottawa, all good games. I mean, that's going to challenge
them
enough.
And they finish with DeKalb.
Yeah. It's a great end of the season, and it's what they need because they've had such a, I guess, an easy way out of it in the first half.
Well, I look at Geneseo, and those kids know how to win. They know how to handle their business. So, yeah, we can scrutinize their schedule, but they are still getting it done, and they're winning how they should be winning against a situation like that. It'd be one thing if they're squeaking some out, but, you know, at the end of the day, they've had four shutouts. I believe that hasn't happened in, like, 11 years, something like that. So they're playing well. And we'll see. It'll be interesting the next couple weeks if they win on Friday. For sure, gives them their 54th consecutive winning season, which to me is the most impressive high school football stat in the state right now.
I think they do win Friday easily. Mm-hmm. I mean, Yorkville's a good challenge. It'll be a good game. It'll be a way better game than I've seen so far this season. But I think Geneseo is going to be too much. The real game's next week.
That's Sterling. And Sterling has the most wins against Geneseo, tied with Rochelle as anybody else. Sterling has always played Geneseo consistently well. Now we move on from the Maple Leafs to the Western Big Six, and we have Marc Nesseler, who I guess now will be Alex Trebek, a silent Alex Trebek, holding up some cue cards here. Okay, best team in the Western Big Six after 2 weeks. I would have to say, based on what Quincy did to Alleman, that it's got to be the Blue Devils, for the simple fact of Ness is not agreeing with us. That's fine. But for the simple fact of what they did to Alleman, and a lot of coaches felt like Quincy was the team to beat in the Big Six this year anyway. So I'd have to go with Quincy right off the bat. What do you think on that one?
The thing with Quincy last week, they put 63 points. That's impressive. Nobody's done that since 2001 to Alleman. I go with Galesburg, though. They're 2-0. They're the front runners right now. I mean, they've got Quincy left, right?
Correct. They have to host Quincy.
I think Galesburg's the best team.
Well, I look at from this situation. Has Galesburg truly been tested? They hosted Moline. Now they got to come on the road. They have to go. They did play Moline, and they won at home. This will be a test with Alleman, going to Alleman, then playing, hosting Rock Island, then having to go to Flynn Stadium to play Quincy. That's going to be a test. Very easily, at least one loss in that stretch there. I still think at the end of the day, it's Quincy that I'm saying is the best team. Is the best team. Best defense in the Western Big Six. Statistically, it's got to be Moline. Wouldn't you agree?
I would say Moline, and I like Moline in general. I mean, right now, Galesburg's the best team in the conference for me, but I like what Moline's doing these last couple of weeks, and Mike Tracy's got those guys playing the right way. It's certainly good to see those guys winning again. I think they could be they could make a run at the Big Six in my eyes.
It's very interesting, but he's going with Galesburg, and I understand that. Best rushing defense in the Big Six belongs to Moline. Their scoring defense is pretty. Moline has been consistent, and if you look up, they've given up some points, but one of the big ones was against Antioch, where they gave up some. The defense or their offense gave up some defensive touchdowns, something like that. And Galesburg, yes, I agree, they're good, but I just still don't think that that's the team that can go and beat Alleman, beat Rock Island, and beat Quincy to finish up the Big Six. I don't believe that they're going to go 3-0 in that stretch. I just don't see that happening. Next cue card, Nas. Best offense in the Big Six? Okay, I mean, at Quincy. Quincy. They put up 28 against Rock Island.
I'll say
and they
Quincy.
They felt that they should have won. 63 against Alleman, and just how explosive they are and how diversified they are in the backfield. They have three guys that can go off at any point in time. They have three guys with 400 rushing yards or more. I just think it's Quincy, their ability to run the football and be physical. It's Quincy without a doubt.
I like Quincy too. 63 against Alleman is just enough for me to say that.
I just
that.
Still can't believe that. I cannot believe that at all. This week's what? Games. We have the big one, Quincy invading Browning Field, that new scoreboard.
Yeah.
That's going to be key. Hopefully they have agency spelled right on the scoreboard this week at Browning Field. That we'll leave that for another time. Agency, that is correct. That is how
very
you correctly
good,
that's
very
how you
good.
Correctly spell agency. United Township hosting Rock Island. Yeah. Rock Island's won the last three meetings there. That's Rock Island on paper should be able to win that handily. You would think, but I just like to see what Dakari Mars can continue to do for UT. He's leading the Big Six in rushing, has 80 yards more than anybody else in the league. Think that Rock Island can beat your alma mater. We have Ness's alma mater against Anthony's alma mater, UT. And then the last one, this is a key one too. Galesburg at Alleman. What do you think of that one?
I'm going to have to say Galesburg over Alleman. It'd be nice to see Alleman respond with a bounce back win against Galesburg, but I can't see that.
What you said was striking, respond. I don't see Alleman laying over like that. I think that they were pretty disgusted with their performance at Quincy, and you'd think that they would be able to rebound pretty well. Ness has got something on the cue card. Team zeroing in on Mars. Well, that's been the case this season, but he still has 800 rushing yards this season.
Yeah, he's quite impressive. I like Moline this week over Quincy, just for the reason that 2 weeks ago Shaq Davis said Galesburg really punched him in the mouth.
Yeah.
They came out, punched Rock Island in the mouth. Mm-hmm. This week, why not punch Quincy in the mouth to make a run at this Big Six title?
I want to make a statement about the Big Six right now and how many people are just whining and complaining. Oh, the Big Six is no good. This is just terrible. But you just don't know what's going to happen. The unpredictability of it, the parity of it, makes every single week insane because you don't. Who knows what could happen? Who would have thought in the third week that five of the six teams would already have a loss on it? 3-2, 2-3. Yeah, that's the interesting part of all of this.
And not only the Western Big Six, the Northern Illinois Big 12 on the west side.
Yes.
That's a good little race. Sterling and Ottawa both.
Which is surprising because the East has been the better of the two divisions for the last several years, and now it seems like the strength of it is going over the West division.
I still think Geneseo probably gets past both and takes the division title undefeated again.
I want to get a quick area glance on here. Orion, does it seem to be to me that they are the team to beat in the air, that they have kind of proven themselves to be the elite among the area
absolutely.
Teams?
Absolutely. They beat EP in week two, and then last week was just another huge win, 7-0. Defensive touchdown was the difference, right?
Yes. And who would have thought? I mean, that was the first time in like 63 games that Rockridge has been shut out. And Orion is known for putting up huge points and winning 7-0. Nobody could have predicted that. And one last one, Anawan Wethersfield, Mercer County. That's a key Lincoln Trail game. It's at Wethersfield. Does Mercer County rebound or does Anawan Wethersfield find a way to continue winning?
I think they continue to find a way to win.
And W to
Hot.
That's correct.
Too hot.
Okay, we've managed to somehow silence Marc Nesseler, so we consider that a W today.
I actually like it this way.
Yes, we consider that one a dub today. Anthony, great having you on here. Ness, we hope you feel better. We appreciate your time this time. Until next time, so long for just a while.